We'll continue with our topic exercise 6.3. We finished doing three problems. The next problem. There is a figure here. You can see one triangle PRT, another triangle TQS. Angle PRT is given to be 40 degree. Angle TSQ is given as 75 degree, then RPT given as 95 degree, you need to find angle SQT. The measurements of angle P, angle R, angle S are given. You need to find angle Q. So for that, I'm taking two variables. I'm going to write a X variable over here, a Y here. Angle T is angle X. Angle Q is angle Y. So now we'll do the problem. Consider triangle PRT. What all are the angles of triangle PRT? Angle P, angle R, angle T. The sum of the angles of a triangle equals 180 degree. Measurement of angle P given as 95. Measurement of angle R given as 40. Measurement of angle T, X equals 180. Therefore, what will be the value of X? 180 minus 95 plus 40. Do the simplification in your working column and get the answer. You will get the answer as 180 minus 135, which is equal to 45 degree. So, I got X equals 45 degree. If this is 45 degree, what can you say about this angle? These two angles are which type of angle? Vertically opposite angle. Vertically opposite angles are equal. So, if this is 45, this angle is also 45. So, now consider triangle TSQ. Angle T 45, angle S 75. So, how will you find angle Q? Again, with the help of angle sum property. 45 plus 75 plus Y is equal to 180. Therefore, angle Q, which is equal to Y, equals 180 minus 45 plus 75. And what will be 180 minus 45 plus 75 equals, that will be equal to 60 degree. Therefore, angle SQT equals 60 degree. This is what we need to find. Next question. There is a figure given. PT perpendicular PS, PQ parallel SR, angle S, QR 28 degree, QRT 65 degree. You need to find the values of X and Y. So, unknown variables are there X and Y. A figure is given, angle P is 90 degree. These two lines are parallel, PQ parallel SR. Or same as PQ parallel ST. If two lines are parallel, alternate interior angles will be equal. So, if this is angle X, definitely this will also be angle X. Then, if I take the value A here, A plus 65 degree is equal to 180. Reason, linear pair. So, A will be 180 minus 65. Do it in your working column. What is 180 minus 65? What will you get there? Then, X plus 28 plus A equals 180 degree. That is angle sum property. You can find the value of X like that. Or That means use angle sum property. Or another method, if this is a triangle, x plus 28 is equal to, what will be the exterior angle? 65. So what's the value of x? 65 minus 28. And what will be 65 minus 28 is equal to 37 degree. So there are two ways to do the value, to find the value of x. Either you can use angle sum property or you can use exterior angle property. Any one method you can use and find it. I just wrote the options. Whichever way you do, it will be correct. Once you know the value of x, if this is 37, definitely this angle will be also 37, alternate interior angles. Now you consider the triangle PQS. Triangle PQS, angle P plus angle Q plus angle S equals 180 degree, angle P 90 degree, angle Q means X, that is 37 degree, plus Y equals 180 degree. Therefore Y equals 180 minus 90 plus 37. So what will be the value of y? It will be 53 degree. Therefore, x equals 65, y equals 53 degree. This will be the answers. Next question. Side QR of triangle PQR is produced to a point S. This is QR, side QR of which triangle PQR is produced to S. That means there is a triangle PQR. The side QR is extended to S. If bisectors of angle PQR and PRS, PQR, find the bisectors. If the bisectors of angle PQR and PRS. Angle bisector, as in the above problem I have said, what is meant by an angle bisector? The line which cuts the angle into two equal halves. The bisectors of angle PQR. This is angle PQR. This is the bisector. What is the name of the bisector? QT. And bisector of angle PRS. PRS. So what is the name of the bisector here? RT. If the bisectors of PQR and PRS meet at T, prove that angle QTR is equal to half of angle QPR. I hope you understood the question. There is a triangle PQR. QR has been extended to the point S. Then the angle bisector of Q and the angle bisector of R meet at the point T. Then you need to prove that angle QTR is equal to half of angle QPR. Now we'll start doing the proof. Triangle PQR extended to S. That figure I have drawn here. Without drawing the angle bisectors, I have simply drawn triangle PQR. Side QR is extended to S. By exterior angle property, exterior angle PRS is equal to sum of the interior two angles. Angle PRS is equal to angle PQR plus angle QPR. That is our exterior angle property. Now, I am going to take half on both the sides or multiply by 1 by 2 on both the sides of the equation. Half into angle PQR plus half into angle
QPR.
Half of angle PRS from the main figure. This is PRS, this angle. Half of angle PRS means either this one or this angle. The name is angle TRS. Half of angle PRS means it can be angle TRS also. Equals half of angle PQR. This is PQR. Half means this or this. For our answer, I am going to write angle TQR. So half of angle PQR is same as angle TQR plus half of angle QPR. This is my first equation. So I have just taken this figure, I have redrawn it. I didn't draw the angle bisectors there. I have simply drawn a triangle PQR. Side QR is extended to S. By exterior angle property, angle PRS is equal to sum of the interior angles. Then multiplying by half on both the sides of the equation, half PRS is equal to half into angle PQR plus half into angle QPR. Then half of angle PRS is angle TRS is equal to PQR, which is same as angle TQR plus angle QPR. That equation I am going to write it as equation 1. Then the same figure here I have drawn, but it is another triangle QTR. QTR. This same figure I have just drawn the other side, angle triangle TQR. Then here what is the exterior angle? Angle TRS is equal to sum of interior opposite angles, angle TQR plus angle QTR. Then I am going to name this as my second equation. When you check the first equation and the second equation, when you check the first equation and the second equation, you can see that LHS of both the equations are angle TRS, angle TRS. If LHS are equal, I can equate the RHS also. So I can rewrite it as angle TQR plus half of angle QPR equals angle TQR plus angle QTR. TQR on both the sides gets cancelled. So what is left? Half angle QPR equals half angle QTR. Hence the proof. So go through these problems clearly. So there was a figure given. I have divided the figure into two small figures. I have taken triangle PQR, used the exterior angle property. Then I multiplied by half on both the sides. Then I got angle TRS is equal to angle TQR plus half angle QPR. That is the first equation. Then the next part of the triangle, you can see here QTR. The same figure I have drawn here. Here also exterior angle is equal to sum of interior opposite angles. From both the equation, your LHS is equal, then you can equate the RHS. Angle TQR, angle TQR gets cancelled, and then you will get the required form.